Hi there, and welcome or welcome back to this channel. This September, I knitted the sweater of my dreams, and I can't wait to tell you all about it in this video. Ever since I've started knitting, I have been dreaming about making myself a perfect cashmere sweater. And this summer, lucky me received a gorgeous cashmere yarn from Cardiff Cashmere as a gift. Cardiff Cashmere Classic is 100% cashmere yarn that is marketed as a DK weight, but I would say it's more of a sport weight yarn. There is 120 meters per 25 gram skein. It is extremely soft, fluffy and lightweight, and they have it in the color 709. I had a very clear vision about what kind of sweater I would like to make, but there weren't a lot of pattern options out there that would fit my vision. I was looking for a sweater with about 10 cm of positive ease, simultaneous satin sleeve construction, double folded collar, 2x2 ribbing and split body hem. The main challenge was to get a knitted shoulder and sleeves construction and hit the gauge, so the best option I could find was to modify petite knits poppy tee. The poppy tee sample was knitted up using the same yarn that I had, and the shoulder and sleeves construction was exactly what I was looking for. And it wasn't a problem for me to modify the ribbing and knit the sleeves longer. The poppy tee is intended to be quite fitted, with only 5 cm of positive ease. I want my sweater to be a little bit more relaxed and oversized, so I have decided to knit a size bigger. I will be making size medium instead of the usual small. I also made the gauge of 23 stitches per 10 cm using my 4mm needles instead of the suggested in the pattern 3.5. So all things seem to be sorted out now, and that means that we are ready to cast on. This is my first time working on a pattern with simultaneous satin sleeve construction, so I'm very excited. The pattern starts the same way as a regular drop shoulder piece. I cast on stitches for the back panel, aka back yoke, and shape it by making the increases along each side. However, the back panel in this pattern is much shorter than the one you would usually knit in a drop shoulder piece, so I'm ready to move on to the next step. I now pick up stitches for the shoulders along both shoulder seams. And work on them back and forth while making the increases for the front. Honestly, this looks like a beginning of a sweater for a baby. And here is when things get interesting. I'm now turning it into a raglan sweater, so for the next step I'm getting my stitch markers prepared. To start working on the yoke, I'm picking up the stitches along shoulders that will now be my sleeve stitches. And I'm connecting all the pieces together. I'm truly amazed by this yoke construction, and I think it's such a great alternative to usual raglan and drop shoulder pieces, even though it's actually just a combination of both. Now I will be working back and forth while doing increases in all sections, the same way you would do in a raglan sweater. It's time now to cast on stitches for the front and join the working around. Important step for me here is to change one marker to a different one to mark the beginning of the round so that I don't get lost. And then I can work in the round on the yoke while continue doing increases at all sections for body and both sleeves. I have now reached the point where I can split for the body and the sleeves. So far it has been such an enjoyable project. I love the pattern and the knitting process a lot. And of course yarn. It's so incredibly soft and lightweight, it glides on the needle so easily and feels so good. I try to take pauses and not to rush through this project so that I can enjoy it for as long as I can. And now I feel like it's a good time for a first try-on. First try-ons are weird. They don't really tell you a lot about how the garment will fit at the end, but can affect how you feel about the piece so much. And what can I say? This is definitely a successful try-on and deserves a happy dance at the end. I'll now be working on the body in the round. I have now managed to add about 10 cm to the body and I'm currently finishing up the skein of yarn before I switch to knitting the collar. Here is how the sweater looks now and I'm obsessed. Can't wait to finish it. So now let's make the collar. I pick up stitches as suggested in the pattern, but then I also make sure that the total number of stitches can be divided by 4 since I will be working in 2x2 rib stitch. I'm also using my 3mm circular needles here. I want the collar to be quite high, at least a little bit higher than in the pattern, so I'm working in ribbing until the collar is about 8 to 9 cm long. I also decided to first cast it off and only then sew it all that to make sure that the collar is nice and stretchy and I can get my head through. To additionally ensure that it's nice and stretchy, I'm using my favorite simple stretchy bind-off by Very Pink Knits. And as always, to help me not to mess anything up when sewing the collar, I put 4 stitch markers while folding it carefully and aligning the ribbing. And here it is! I love 2x2 ribbing because it's much easier for me to make it neater. Now I'm ready to start working on the sleeves. I love knitting sleeves on my short 10cm circulars. Can't stop trying on this piece. Really want to see how the color looks. Isn't it just so lovely? Here is the point where sleeves sit. And now I can back to working on the sleeves. For the sleeves, I picked up stitches for the underarm as suggested in the pattern and was doing decreases on every 9th round. At first I did 10 rounds of decreases before starting the ribbing. For the ribbing I've used 3mm needles, and again before starting the ribbing I make sure that the number of stitches can be divided by 4. For the cast-off I used the Kitchener stitch technique. At the first step I split all the stitches onto 2 needles, on one all the knits and on another all the purls, and then I Kitchener stitch them together. Maybe there is an easier way to do that for 2x2 ribbing, but I just know and love Kitchener stitch. And now another try on. I love the length, but the ribbing feels a little bit too tight, especially at the cast off. Since the yarn I'm using is very delicate, I don't want to have any unwanted tension as it might cause the yarn to wear out quickly or even break at high tension point. So I will knit the second sleeve slightly different to see if it helps. Every time I try on my sweater, I feel a bit scared that the neck color might stretch too much, so I want to put elastic right away to be on a safe side. I do it for all of my knits with colors. I'm threading in an elastic between two sides of my folded collar. The main challenge for me here is to make sure that I do it properly and the elastic is not visible from the outside. After that, I just tied 2 knots and that's it. And now back to the sleeve. For my second sleeve, I decided to do 8 rounds of decreases instead of 10 to make the sleeve a little bit wider at the end. For the ribbing, I decided to use 3.5mm needles instead of 3mm to make it even more relaxed. I knit one row with 4mm needles to also help me do Kitchener stitch not too tightly. And then I'm using the same technique for the cast off as for the first sleeve. Seems like my second sleeve is for sure wider and more relaxed at the cast off edge. It even flares a bit, but feels for sure nicer. I will now just take away some extra yarn from the cast-off edge to make it a bit neater. Now let's remake the first sleeve. I'm unraveling it to the point where I did my 8th round of decreases and just knit straight. Ta-da! Both sleeves are done, and I'm very much happy with them. Now it's time to get back to work on the body. I'm putting my stitches back on the needle from a stitch holder and start knitting round by round. This project is bringing me so much joy. Can't wait to finish this sweater and finally wear it, but also don't want this to end. As always, I'm struggling with figuring out how long I want the body to be, and at what point I should start doing the ribbing. Trying your work in progress with jeans definitely helps to get a sense of the desired length, but comparing it with the lengths of other knitwear helps even better. So let's see. I'm putting on my sweater number 14 V-neck by My Favorite Things Knitwear. I love it a lot and I want to do the split hem for my poppy sweaters the same way. But I think I will make the ribbing few centimeters shorter to match my sleeves ribbing better. According to my calculations, I still need to knit a few centimeters before starting the hem, so I put a stitch marker to measure my progress. And now let's start working on the ribbing. I divided the total number of body stitches by 2, but double checked that the number of stitches on each side can be divided by 4. The first and the last stitch are edge stitches, so I slip the first purlwise and knit last one to make the edges look neat, and the hem starts and ends with 2 knit stitches. I'm using the 3.5mm needles as for the ribbing on my sleeves. I make the back ribbing about 9.5cm long, so that when I block it and stretch to the same width as the body, the length will be about 9cm. And again I use the Kitchener cast-off method. I do the front hem the same way, but to the point where it measures about 7.5cm, so 2cm shorter than the back. Here is a quick try-on before casting off. And here is after. For now it's quite snug and I hope it will get more relaxed after blocking. When blocking, I put my sock blockers into the sleeves to help them stay straight and not cinch it, because I don't have proper blocking supplies. And here it is. It's so, so beautiful. Love all the details. Just need to cut the ends and we are done. It looks and feels so, so much better after blocking. I never had these wow transformation moments when blocking my knits, but here the blocking really did its magic. This was a very lovely knitting process. The pattern is of course well written, but the construction is what makes this pattern special. The detail I loved the most about this pattern was that there were no German short rows for the sleeves. I should admit that I hate doing German short rows to shape the sleeves, because first, the process is just not the most enjoyable one, and second, I cannot unsee that one wonky row with German short rows afterwards. On another hand, I love the process of knitting a raglan sweater, but I don't really like how the raglan detail is looking on me, And this pattern doesn't look like a raglan, but most of the yoke is knitted using raglan increases, which is just so cool. I'm just so happy about it that I'm already having plans about modifying poppy tee into a cardigan. On the yarn side, of course, cashmere yarn is a dream to work with. For this sweater of my size, I used a bit more than 10 balls of Cardiff Cashmere Classic. Because it is so lightweight, my sweater weighs about 260 grams. For comparison, my sweaters usually weigh about 600 grams. And despite being so lightweight, it's still very, very warm, at least for the climate I live in. Even though it's very soft, I still get a slight irritation on my neck when wearing it without a cotton t-shirt or a long sleeve underneath. So if you have a very sensitive skin, even cashmere can be irritating, which still surprises me. And the billing. I knew this one would bill as it was just too soft not to. I was just hoping that billing wouldn't get too bad. At the moment of recording this shot, I wore this sweater about 10 times and didn't remove any lint so far. You can definitely see that there is some lint, but it's not too bad and I can easily remove it with my electric shaver. I also cannot not mention that cashmere is a very expensive fiber. If I would buy this yarn myself, I would have to pay about 140 euros for the sweater of my size. And I guess everyone decides for themselves whether it's worth it or not. Even though I'm really and honestly happy with my sweater, I still feel that I can be quite biased since I haven't paid for this yarn myself. So this was the story about my perfect sweater, and on that note we reached the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video and would like to support me, please give me a thumbs up and leave a comment down below. It means the world to me. I'll see you in the next one and wish you a lovely time till then.